and they put some trails and stuff. Focus on the placement of primary and secondary info and alternate routes to meet users' business goal. This one a bit too technical. You need to observe and then look at Google Analytics and they tell you that your user, you think that they go A, B, C, D, E, but in fact they go A, C, D, F, H. Okay? So this is the part that where your design and your actual user behavior is different. You have to monitor that. And then choices of the interface design are the search bar, sign up button, pop-up, text fields, checkboxes, and so on. I'll leave it to you all to play around later when I show you the tools. A common pitfall is that anything they put into the system, they add a development cost to you. Okay? This is a bit old school, where people are still not very familiar with technology. I will show you a website later. Yeah, I give you some example. Yeah, this website is called heavenworks.com.
Wow.
One of the most popular websites in America still. Yeah, see, they have TV. Netscape Navigator. This doesn't look strange for you, right? This is how website looks like last time. Correct? Yeah. In fact, you go to Taobao, Alibaba.com, you still practice this. Yeah. Chinese website is slightly different. They still practice this. You go Muga also similar to this. Why? Because Asian doesn't like to be instructed what to do. I want to have the full freedom. You just give me everything, okay, I pick what I want. Yeah, same thing when you go to a shop. Okay, you go to a boutique, you go to a fashion shop. Then the counter girl can ask you, oh sir, how can I help you? And double the thing already. Okay. Experience Award 2014 Grand Prize. Yeah, it's a virgin American. You can have a look. Yeah. That's why their website is relatively cleaner. Okay, you go in. Yes. Nothing, just a culture thing. Okay, some of you designer background, some of you have programmers background. Yesterday, Sean asked, right? Yeah, then you argue, oh no. Comic Sans is the best font, no? Everybody has it on their computer. I said, no. Comic Sans is too ugly, too childish. Let's use Times New Roman, looks more professional. So it looks closely resembled to the actual product, okay, with the content and stuff. But usually the text you just put a lot of decent. So it comes to fidelity comparison. The low fidelity things will have very minimal stuff. It's easier, faster, cheaper to draw. Actually it's just nice. Okay, if you can't form a team, just let me know.
Okay. Tree. So, NEEM, N-E-E-M. Environmental, MNC, all this, those green, no?
Green.
Okay. The key activities. Okay, key activities, we have to go and find the seeding, find the seed. Okay, nurture the seeding until 1 year. Then 2 years, you can start to find.
We need to get the sponsor by the government.
Okay.
Most of the authority.
Why on earth are you doing
this?
Lubricant. More specific, lubricant. Lubricant. Okay. Car lubricants. So these are the common usual suspects that you will find in this sort of activity. Okay. Someone said I hate food. No, I don't hate food. Okay. I love food. It's just F and B business of stuff. The real solution, right? Everybody when you wake up, you think of food. I'll share it with another group also. When you think of your application, right, you need to think about the stickiness. Okay. So what is the motivation that people use it? It goes back to my vitamin and painkiller theory yesterday. So, like my auntie in Australia, she put on Facebook, she just sees a picture of her grandson, granddaughter, playing around. She still feel connected in some way. Okay, this is one of the motivation that people use Facebook. And then for some people, like a bit mid-20s to say mid-30s, 25 to 35, especially they're singles, they got nothing to do, so they have to check. Oh, someone, oh, in relationship, lost a chance. So that will, but I thought coming donut, two to a couple of variety, different sizes. So it goes back to the McDonald's BK case, but I'm not going there. So on your left, okay, if your problem is to solve hunger, right, must you eat donut? Must you eat donut? So do you still think that donut is solving a problem of hunger or hungry? This is something weird.
Then you have MVP. MVP and prototype is very, very close. So most of the time, if we were to do that, we usually merge them together. You don't want to waste too much time in these two. And then after that, you have your full-fledged product. You develop the complete product.
I guess it's man-made. Okay, not the bonus. Not like, or not gonna be bitten by some unknown bug. Not like Spider-Man style or something. The first image is not clear, but you can see that the first one is a wireframe. So he gone through the same stages. How anyone watch all the Iron Man 1, 2, 3 and then
okay, so you agree with me, right? So the first thing he did is he draw a wireframe.
Spider-Man also do the same thing, like, if you remember in Spider-Man 1, his very first costume is ugly as hell. So the second thing he did a mock-up and then he got some failure and stuff. Then after that he developed a prototype. And then he still didn't show to the public. He cannot use his prototype again, but he should lose. Then after that, he has an MVP. Then this is, I think this is Iron Man 2 or 3, I forgot. The last one. The first one didn't come out, right?
Yeah. Okay. Because of things like colors, red button, blue button, and stuff. But also, you want to spot potential issues or structures at the early stage. So some of you go all over, right? You want to have as many pages, as many tabs. Yeah, but now you want to spot potential issues that when user use a website, okay, or use an app, what are the problems that they're going to face? They can't watch videos. Especially nowadays, people have very, very short attention span. Right? Shorter than goldfish. You watch a YouTube tab here, the next moment you hear ding on your Facebook tab, and you switch over, and then you forgot you're watching a YouTube. Right? Okay, this is what happens. So some people, they have very, very short, most of us, we have very, very short attention span. But some people, they are more visual, okay? Some people, they are more kinesiotic, okay? They need to touch something, they need to use it, then only they, you know.
Now, this is something very, very aesthetic about Asian culture, right? How many of you think that Asian listen? Asian, I say, okay, or I just say Malaysian. We listen, we like to listen more.
They listen,
but it goes out the outside. Okay, that's a good one. How many of you think that they listen? Malaysians, okay, like to listen. Just raise your hand, doesn't matter. So we agree that people will listen, right? They're prone to listen something, right? How many of you think that people would like to see? I give you an example. In Malaysian culture, you only see your name. Chinese lah, okay, all Chinese, Asian, Malaysian, Malay, Indian, they like to see your name. I give you evidence, this is a fact. So let's say today, you hear from someone, okay, so Okay, this is the easiest one. You have family, so you have your father, right? So you know someone is lying to you. So your younger son say, the elder brother, abang dia tengah gaduh lah, okay, fighting with someone outside. Okay? Same thing. I said, you complain until so long, complain to me half an hour. You only give two or three, I'll give one. Then my mother will go, oh, that's a story already. You know why the car is so dirty? Maybe because they got kids. Right. So the perspective that I'm presenting to you is not about the human, you know. But I'm giving you the very technical part of how we are going to execute the startup. A lot of people wondering why is it so hard to execute startup in Malaysia? Right? You look at America, you look at other countries, why they can raise funds so easily. That's why, because you're doing the thing wrong. Okay? So tech business. Sometimes if you're not techie,
you worry that your server cannot take it, you don't have enough funds to do this and do that. So you better test it at a smaller scale, then only you scale it up. You optimize the performance, okay? Sometimes this thing works well with 1,000 users, 2,000 users. When you hit 3,000 users, suddenly your whole thing cracks, and you don't know why. Is it another 1,000 users only now? How come so? But eventually, it will lead to your final product, okay? Your fully developed product. So your wireframe, your mockups, or your MVP, and then you do your final product. Technically strong guy that can go straight to Photoshop and Illustrator, for example, you don't tell him, hey, no, you do wireframe first because Dr. Lau said so. He's going to leave you. Yeah, okay? Optional, yeah. It's a typical timeline. All your important things stay on the left, because you might read from left to right. Only when you're lying, then you look upwards. Yeah. Otherwise, you read from left to right most of the time. Again, simple shapes like squares, like rounds, and things like that. That's why you realize that in your PowerPoint, in your Adobe, in whatever tools that you're using, right, they only give you a few simple shapes. The main thing is only your squares and your circles. No, not Google. Facebook, pretty close.
Yahoo.
Insta. There's no picture.
Google Plus.
Be Insta. No, not Google. Twitter is the right one. Okay, so these are wireframes of Twitter. You can see it's from Jack Dorsey, Flickr. We got it there. Yeah. So when they started, the homepage of the website is just like a shop. You build a shop. Nobody will know your shop like this one. Okay, today if you open a cafe in Damansara or KL, nobody will know your cafe in there. Directly. Okay, people will come by, walk past. Okay, nobody knows. Okay. But if you have a landing page or you have an app, it's different. App usually is for you to do one thing. Okay? Basically, you want to settle some problem. You go WhatsApp. You go to WhatsApp, you basically want to chat with somebody. Okay? You want to reply a message, you want to talk to someone. That's why you use WhatsApp. If you want to do some other thing, you go to some other app. So apps is very task-oriented. Okay? Every single app, it handles one thing or one task. So this is the Twitter. So they started with this stuff. You put in your name, your email, your phone number, and then that particular box is for you. Very simple for you to enter things, 160 characters. Anybody know why when Twitter started, they limit to 140 characters only? Optimized for performance? Not really. The initial performance is very, very bad. They were written on Ruby on Rails. Why does the Twitter limit you to 140 characters?
To tally the concept of tweet.
To tally the concept of?
Tweet.
Tweet. But they are the one came up with the concept of tweet. Tally, you can write. 160, but they have to give some buffer and stuff. They need to put in some control characters. But around there, 140 to 160. Okay? That's the right answer. So after that, when you have your wireframes, you usually go between wireframes and mockups. So on your left is your wireframes, and on your right is your mockup. Okay. Now, information that facilitates understanding. So it's like a information architecture. Okay. This is textbook stuff. You don't have to memorize. What else? Everything is missing. Okay. I can tell you. Search is missing, blog is missing. Okay, if you go to my homepage, then it's a totally different thing. It's a totally different thing. So you have all the information. So this is like your storefront and also a particular action that you want them to do. So when you design your wireframe, right, you have to think about what is the actual thing that you want them to do. Okay? When people come here, they say, I'm not too worried, they go and click on my face for what? I never say click my face to get freaking over. Yeah. Okay? So this is the role of your homepage and also your landing page. But we'll go into details in there.